Welcome back, one. Welcome back, all. It's the Mad Catz CSGO Invitational. I am Jay Atkins yet again, and he is still Walkline. No changes. No change on that front.
No.
So we're good, though. We got the introductions nailed. Knife Run going to be underway momentarily here in the VERYGAMES CRG matchup. Now, CRG, obviously, the only UK representation in this tournament. I would have to say they're probably the most underdog team in the tournament, considering that the UK scene is yet to really find its feet. So it's not like they have a ton of practice partners and things. So I think to get to this point, they've done fairly well. I did allude to this before. They do represent the UK really well as well. I mean, you know, Spuds and Reason. I have never seen them flaming on forums, which for UK players is almost unheard of.
Yeah, that's kind of their forte, really, flaming everyone on forums and stuff. So, yeah, a really nice bunch of lads at Team CRG. You want to do the Alienware roster rundown?
I certainly will. That'd be my pleasure. So the Alienware basically roster rundown is going to be VERYGAMES on your CT side. You can tell I'm tired. Got Kenny S, MBK, of course, Scream, Smiths, and Existence. So your standard sort of VERYGAMES setup these days. For Team CRG, we've got Drone, Ben, Reason, Red Snake, and Spuds Online. That concludes your Alienware roster rundown, and we are now underway with the pistol round. So we're not really messing around here. We're going to get this underway. And to be honest, I think this is going to be a relatively short game. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, I totally agree. Obviously, it would be fun to see this British team do well against VERYGAMES, but I'm having trouble seeing it, really. VERYGAMES have been playing all day, so these basic flaws they had in the start of the day should really be ironed out by now.
Yep, I agree. I think the communication issues that we've seen, if Regnum still has anything to do with the team, which I'd be surprised if he didn't, to be honest, because he is, you know, very dedicated to that VERYGAMES brand.
Cornerstone.
Not just as you know, an esports manager, but also, you know, as the server company as well. He's heavily involved with them, so I'd be surprised if he isn't a part, and if he is, you guarantee words were said about the performances earlier today. Anyway, we are seeing looks like a big banana stack here. CRG now going to be pushing in. Good nade, though. Actually, only tickles Spuds and Ben, so wasn't as good as I was anticipating, to be honest. They must have found cover behind the barrels, though. I guess you wouldn't even call them barrels, actually, but yeah, the cover on the corner as you come into banana, basically. And we are seeing lots of USP fire from the back of sight. It looks like we are going to see the Glock shut down here on the entry. Smith double headshots. Red Snake going to reply, and he's going to get the second frag as well, but eventually dropped in return from Existence. Now, Existence did look towards Ruins, though. He thought there was perhaps a cheeky push around. It kind of didn't work in his favor, though, as he turns his back. We did see the push coming in, so cheeky neg going down to site. Really didn't do enough damage, though, so kind of a bit of a waste, though. True Man retake coming in. Make that 2-on-1 now. We're going to see the final kill coming in from Kenny. Double the most clutch opportune moment. He's going to have plenty of time for that 10-second defuse. So, first pistol run going the way of VERYGAMES here. Much expected, to be honest, even considering the Glock bias. I think we are going to see relatively close to a shutout here. I think if CRG can walk away with, say, 7 rounds, I know it's not a particularly great score, but I think 7 rounds against VERYGAMES, who are probably going to be resurgent from this afternoon, I mean, that's fairly respectable, especially considering that, you know, the UK scene is the shambles that it is at the moment. So,
yeah, that scoreline is something they can, I think, they can be proud of and build upon.
Yeah,
and will give them the motivation to keep at it and just practice harder, really.
Not only that, it's going to mean that the rest of the UK scene are going to take notice and say, look, we beat CRG on a regular basis in scrims.
Yeah.
They managed to do fairly well at the Mad Catz Invitational. What could we do?
Yeah.
So hopefully, it forces some of the UK teams to actually to pull the finger out and actually get on it. Anyway, we are seeing the banana rush here. Again, lots of FAMAS fire coming in from MBK here. We've also got the crossfire setup from Scream, who obviously, you know, relatively new replacement. He's been holding his own, though, hasn't he, Walker?
Yeah, more than that, really. He's been pretty much fragging for two throughout the games I've seen. So, yeah, he's filling in quite well. The only thing missing for the VERYGAMES lineup is for them to gel a little bit more and to have that consistency as a team and as a unit.
Yeah, that will come with time, though.
I mean,
obviously, four of them already have that in place. And I'm pretty sure Scream is a smart enough player where he can bring his transferable skills.
Yep.
Now we are seeing 2-on-1 here. In fact, now we've got the rotation coming in. It's going to make it a 4-on-1 situation for Ben. He's not going to get out of that with a plant. No way. That's 2-0 scoreline. Eco Bash is coming in. We should see another round going the way of VERYGAMES here. As you can see from the scoreboard, really what you're looking at is just Kenny dominance. For my money, I think Kenny is probably the the best player on VERYGAMES these days. I mean, it used to be, you know, Smith. Smith was just devastating with the AWP.
Yeah, and RPK.
And you could also make an argument from RPK on his best days. But for my money these days, Kenny is where it's at.
Yeah, he's such a young player, filled with motivation, and I think he's probably one of the most passionate and dedicated players of VERYGAMES now, and that's pretty much what you need in a game like this, like constantly being on that server and all, putting down smokes everywhere. Talking about smokes, not a problem shooting people through it.
Yeah, existence completely shut down the entry there for the smoke. Just had a good inkling of what angle it was going to be coming in on, so spray and pray does work in goal. Obviously, we've seen a lot of kills through smoke. Red Snake is going to be the last man alive. He's going to be shut down by Kenny on the quad side push. That's going to be the third round third round finished now. Gun round underway momentarily. This is really where if CRG are going to sort of draw anything from this game, it's going to have to be now, isn't it?
It is. Let's see. I've never seen Ben AWP. He's probably always been an AWPer, but I can't say I've really seen him before. So
I will say this. I was quite impressed with CRG's performance against Na'Vi today.
Yeah.
They were actually tied up at 5-5 at one point, which when I came, because pretty much figured it would be a full-blown conclusion. It was going to be as close to a whitewash as we would see in this tournament. So I thought, nah, I'll go for a cigarette. I'll come back in a bit. When I came back, it was 10 rounds had gone. It was 5 apiece. I was ready to eat crow. Yeah. So quite impressed with them. Even when they did get a drubbing after that point, because they didn't really get any more rounds after that in the game. I think they picked up maybe two more after that, tops. But the heads never dropped. So I was quite impressed with the fact, they didn't become despondent. They didn't just fold. They kept playing as hard as they could. And that's all you can ask for. You're never going to improve if you don't give 100%. Even if you know you're going to lose, if you're not giving your utmost effort, you're never going to learn what you need to change.
No.
Yeah, exactly.
The best practice is always against a better team. And if you can't learn from games like that, then it's useless playing against other teams.
Yeah, I mean, at the end of the day as well, iron sharpens iron, and you're not going to get any better by beating up on pub scrubs or anything like that, or going in 5-on-5 mixed channels.
No.
What you will find is, in tournaments like this, no doubt CRG coming out of this, they will have learned a ton of new tricks. They'll have gelled as a team more, because obviously international travel does tend to bring people together.
It does.
You face the same language barriers, you have the same issues when it comes to travel and such, where you've all gone out of your way to get to the event, so everybody's dedicated. I think when they come back to online play in the UK scene, we'll see a marked improvement in the UK-based results. So even if they don't, get past the extended group stages here, wouldn't be surprised to see them improve as a team drastically in very short order, because there's no way you can play against the likes of Na'Vi and VERYGAMES and not take away something from it.
No, well. The problem is it is possible because there's people who rages and don't understand that they're on a completely different level. But I think from what I've seen from these guys before at Team CRG, they're down-to-earth people, and they will see that what they can learn from this. And it looks like we've got a full-on...
Do you want to spot something interesting? Look who's rocking the AWP for VERYGAMES. Well, look who was rocking the AWP.
Yeah.
As Ben gets the counter pick onto him, so there we go. There's one more feather for Ben's cap. It's like Smith's again through smoke. This French team just not taking any prisoners whatsoever. Now it looks like we are going to see Reason. He's going to wait for the peek from the smoke. He knew that he was there, but he didn't want to open up with the AK and give his position away. Now it's Kenny on the retake up banana. Does manage to grab that frag onto Spuds. And you can see MBK moving towards Ruins. He's going to get dropped by Reason with the AK-47 headshot. That leaves Drone at the back of sight. He's got Ben and Reason as cover. One man remaining here, Kenny. If anybody could do it from VERYGAMES, though, Walkline, it's Kenny, isn't it?
It is, but he's not going to do it from T-Spawn, obviously, with that 12 HP and a 4-0 lead. No point in wasting money, Jay. So it's just a good choice to fall back and save that AK.
Yeah, he's got a diffuse kit on him as well, so obviously he's going to have a full body armor. You see 51 body armor, so enough body armor to stop a headshot if it does come his way next time.
Yeah.
From an M4 at least, anyway, not from an AK, of course. So he did make the right decision there. I mean, he is a player who theoretically could clutch that, let's say, a third of the time.
Yeah.
Against players the caliber that he would have been facing there. But yeah, discretion most definitely the better part of valor, and there's no point sort of setting yourself up to have bad habits in tournament play. Even if it is against a team that you should crush, you might as well put your Terry Tryhard face on, because by the time they face NIP or Na'Vi, they will find that, if they've been playing sort of loosey-goosey and just doing what they want, that just will not fly. Anyway, Let's get the auto director on, because I just realized I've been following Kenny like a fanboy for a while here. It does look like we got Team CRG all over the banana bomb site now. Do have a potential retake coming through ruins. 3-on-2 situation. The bomb is up on drone here, so we could very well see a plant. It's just he's got to make the space to actually get that plant down. Now, he could do it here, but to be honest, he would be vulnerable from the rush. As soon as they hear the beeps, they're going to use that as an opportunity to get out of ruins and to flank the site. So he's probably doing the right thing here. He's showing a lot of game sense. Quite impressed. I mean, the fact that he has 47 seconds on the clock, he's got plenty of time to play it out here, but really, I mean, what's Reason? Let's find out what Reason is. Reason's covering ruins here, so they've got a good setup if VERYGAMES do get impatient and push. You see he's going for the barbecue plant as well, so he's got cover from the rush straight down. Looks like we are going to see, it would have been all three members, in fact, of VERYGAMES pushing straight out of ruins back onto site, and they are going to clean that up. It's going to be a mere formality, the defusal here now, so the momentum has been broken, and it looks like we are going to see a 5-1 scoreline, and that's really going to hurt CRG, isn't it? Do you want to explain why that's going to hurt them because of the cash?
Well, yeah, money-wise, that will it will reset the money system pretty much. Obviously, it doesn't hurt them as much as when you've lost six. If you lose six rounds in a row, you will always have enough money, even though you're losing, to buy SAT. And if you then win a round and then lose a round, you will have to lose five more rounds.
It resets it to a $1,500 respawn, basically. And
so it's if you start winning rounds, you need to win rounds, not only one.
Yeah. Sometimes the person who taught me the importance of that was you know Griffin Benja.
Yeah.
Griffin taught me that. He was the first guy to really explain the money system and the intricacies of it, because everyone knows, you know, kills are worth so much, this costs you that much, victory gets you this, but most people tend to not know about the cash resetting at $1,500. So sometimes you can pick up a round, and it can actually be the sort of kiss of death if you lose the next one.
Yeah, kiss of death. That's the perfect explanation for it, really. And it's obviously not something that normal people would pick up on. It's something you learn from professional teams. And here we go. TM CRG moving up to that bomb.
Look at that flash, man. That flash was perfection. That was such good coordination. Triple kill there off that crossfire off the flashbang. Scream with two. And really, I mean, that just shows how prepared VERYGAMES are. To hold that angle and to be so passive on that angle. And basically, his only function there was to put that flash out.
Yeah.
To cover existences.
And then back up after.
And then back up and just open up with the M4 after existence peaks again. That's obviously well drilled and rehearsed. And it seems like, to be honest, CRG aren't really a good indication of VERYGAMES communication at the moment, because they should beat them even without, you know, headsets and, to be honest, without vocal cords.
Yeah.
So, you know, don't read too much into it. It's not necessarily meaning that they've got all the ills from this afternoon sorted out, but it's definitely looking more promising. I still think they could very well finish second here. I think we've just had a shaky opening day. And it does happen. I mean, obviously not to NIP, because they're pretty much godlike, but they're a completely different kettle of fish altogether. Now, you can see, again, Existence setting up here for the push. They're doing it in reverse this time. Scream's baiting them in, and Existence has the HE ready. I don't think CRG are going to fall for it again. Like I say, they've got game sense. It's, you know, it's not a question of if they don't know how to play CS. They obviously do. It just boils down to, you know, the amount of time that VERYGAMES have spent together as a unit, and the way they're coordinating those, you know, flashbang peaks and spray downs, basically.
It is. It's all about the strategies and the individual skill levels here. We'll take that afterwards. A lot of frags being traded. It's down to 2v2, actually. And CRG will get that bomb planted.
Yep. Advantage CRG, but still, VERYGAMES should retake here. Then again, it's 2-on-1 with the bomb down now, so let's switch over to Scream. Scream's probably going to find one frag here. Is he going to get the second? Oh, my God!
Oh, my God. That is...
That was
so
pretty
lucky.
Awkward. Yeah,
that's so lucky.
He was lucky, but it was also pretty awkward. I mean, the stars just aligned there for Scream. He didn't even need to aim.
Nah, exactly.
He ripped through the first target.
Yeah. And killed the other
killed the other one by default. Yeah.
Yeah.
That was pretty insane. So let's have a look at your scoreboard and see how that's affected it. Obviously, Kenny's still in first place, 7-0-1, so only the one death on the board. 3 MVP stars for Kenny. Much as I predicted, he is the standout player these days for VERYGAMES. So consistent, usually top fragging. When he's not top fragging, it's basically because he's fulfilling a role where you're not expected to top frag, where you're expected to support.
Yeah.
Second place in the server is obviously going to be another member of VERYGAMES, that's going to be Scream. So Kenny and Scream, really, I mean, the two newest additions to the VG roster seem to be the guys these days who are pulling the majority of the work here.
Yeah, and a team like VERYGAMES would expect that from their new recruits as well. They're not, they don't want to pick up a player who can't really hold their own and two other players at once. They want people who can pretty much carry the team all by themselves. So yeah, it's
you know. I mean, the thing is with VERYGAMES, so they have five players who can do that.
Yeah, exactly. It's such a great team. It's a lot of fun to watch them play, mainly because all the way they utilize nades in this game is it's mind blowing. They've taken it to a whole different level, and because of VERYGAMES, the Source scene evolved so much. Yep. On tactics.
And it literally was. It was between VERYGAMES, wow, the German scene to a certain degree,
yeah,
and to a, I suppose to a lesser degree, the UK scene, because the UK really, at any one given time, only fielded two top teams. But they were probably the guys who amalgamated everything from all the different scenes.
Yeah.
So when bunny hopping was big, you had Salvo, you know, rushing short A before you even left spawn.
Yeah.
The one thing that the UK scene has been really good at is plagiarizing play styles from different regions,
yeah,
and assembling it into their own game, which is obviously the smart thing to do. If it, yeah, works, steal it.
Why not? It's loud.
Speaking of working, it looks like Drone's going to grab the headshot, so he knows those 7-6-2 rounds are effective. That's going to give him the one-man advantage here, so this is CRG's round now, and it still remains to be seen whether they can capitalize on that one-man advantage, though. And as you can see, it does look like VERYGAMES not really too fussed about losing that initial pick, so they're still trying to bait in off existence here with Scream with the HE behind it. CRG so wary of that now, though. After the triple spray down on Banana.
Yeah,
you can't blame
them,
though, can you?
No, not at all. But VERYGAMES down to 3v5 here, although the majority of the team of Team CRG is very low on HPJ.
Yep, indeed. It's one of those now. One good nade removes the player, brings it back to a 4-on-3.
Yeah.
One good shot to the chest breaks it back to a 3-on-3, and then from that point forward, it's advantage VERYGAMES. Now, Scream opening up with the AK from the back of sight. He's eventually dropped by Drone, so still advantage here to CRG. They do have the bomb on site as well, but as you can see, MBK on the retake. Bomb has gone down, so he does know that there's going to be at least two Ts on that site as it is right now. I don't think it's going to be a massive amount of guesswork for him to realize that Red Snake's going to be on Banana. So, as you can see, he comes through. First thing he checks out is Banana.
Oh, wow.
Just the level of game sense in this VERYGAMES squad, it's beyond reproach, isn't it?
It really is. And I have to point out, NBK has really played it well the last couple of rounds here. Unfortunately, he does not pick up that last kill. And Reason picks up that second round for CRG. And it's still not too late for CRG to get back into this game, but I'm having a hard time seeing it happen, to be
fair.
I
think if they pick up another two rounds out of this first half and then manage to pick up pistols, that'll give them a scoreline where they can walk away heads up high.
Yeah.
Totally. They can leave the tournament and say, look, we got knocked out by probably still on paper the second best team in the whole of Europe, if not the world. No shame in that whatsoever. So, yeah, big fan of CRG just for the fact that, you know, they haven't folded. They've not given any grief to anybody.
No.
They're really good for the UK scene. They're the shot in the arm for the UK scene, you know, a breath of fresh air. So I know it sounds like I'm fanboying over them. It's just obviously I want CSGO to succeed in the UK. And the way it's going at the moment, it could be going better, to be honest. Anyway, we are seeing CRG start to push around. VERYGAMES obviously with the cash to rebuy. So it's not like they're broke here. You can see MBK on the rotation. He's got Kenny behind him as well. So it's going to be a two-man banana retake. They do have flashbangs in reserve to play with here. So we could very well see a successful retake as Spuds and Red Snake don't have anything to repel the retake, and Spuds has already lost 44 HP here. So you would think that if a retake's ever been a formality in an even situation, this would be the one.
Oh, he's going for the
Red Snake on the peak.
Well.
Nice.
Will he get it? Yes, he will get the defuse.
Unlucky for Red Snake, though. He kind of followed the bait and just went for the kill.
Yeah.
MBK was obviously on that bomb in the smoke. I'd imagine he had his French troll laugh going on as that was happening.
Right, so the taser is allowed on the server. Richard, I have to ask you, Mr. Bossman, is tasers allowed in the tournament? Because on the server they could buy it. I see NBK has one.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. Well, yeah, I think they're...
Yeah, I think they're a bit of a gimmick, like Decoy and Molotov, to be honest. I think the money would be better invested into smokes and flashbangs. But then again, when you've got your 9-2 up, you've got that money to play with, you know, why not burn a bit of cash? It's not like VERYGAMES are going to be in a situation here where they're going to be destitute and looking to eco anytime soon. So, can't really blame them for having a bit of fun with it.
No.
It would be interesting if he lost the default round by using the taser, though.
Well, the thing is, CRG would never claim it, but any other UK team would.
Oh, for sure. Rule book out straight away, yeah.
This is not allowed.
To be honest, I know this is a stereotype, but not quite as bad as the German scene for that sort of stuff. Default hunting and the like. But
well, Reason has been playing rather well now as well. He's been picking up a lot of kills. And it's down to a 4v2 now in favor of CRG. And once again, it's not too late to make this half more than decent for them.
Yeah, I mean, theoretically, they could still pull back the standard 9-6 scoreline here that you've come to expect from Inferno. So,
yeah.
I mean, they're not down and out by any stretch of the imagination. I just don't perceive VERYGAMES, you know, easing up like they have done the last couple of rounds. I think they're going to play a lot more passive these next couple of rounds. You're not going to see the peaks that you've been seeing because it seems like CRG have sussed that out now.
Yeah.
They've multiple times they've flashed existence out of the banana site. He's had to retreat through ruins onto gay spot.
Yeah.
And then we've seen at that point then they know where Scream is. They know he's playing deep on site. They know he's playing bomb site cover basically. So they've managed to pick him off and then pick existence off in return. So CRG do seem to be capable of anti-stratting on the fly and picking up on perhaps, you know, the vulnerabilities of the VERYGAMES strats, but it's a matter of mere rounds here, I think, before VERYGAMES start to adjust their strategies to counter the counter. So it's always one of the more interesting aspects of Counter-Strike, to be honest, isn't it, Walker?
It is indeed, and what we're seeing now is VERYGAMES adapting to CRG. They've sacked three players onto that B bomb site with only NBK and Kenny holding down that A bomb site.
Yep. And they've changed it up with Scream going for that aggressive peek onto Banana as well.
Yeah, so by doing that, CRG will not know if there's one, two, or three, or five players on that B bomb site. So for all they know now, it's only that one guy in Banana who has killed two guys. So. Yep. They have no idea.
They don't
idea.
Even know the stacks, though. I mean, it does look like they are starting to shift, but I think that's because they don't want to run into Scream again.
Yeah.
It's not because they know the stacks, though. So they're going to run into two members at the covered site, which means they might get in, but I think they're going to do enough damage on the entry where the retake is going to be more than easy. It's going to be a mere formality, to be quite honest.
Yeah. They have the chance to go through quad, for instance, there and get those two kills and make it a 3v3 and after clamp. But
good existence.
Highly
doubt
that's
it. A greasy spot, man. Yeah. I like that. Oh, Kenny and MBK, not even allowing the entry onto the site. No chance of a bomb plant, though. That's going to make it a 10-3 scoreline. So, distinct possibility that we are going to see a 12-3 here in the first half. That wouldn't surprise me, to be honest. I mean, VERYGAMES, they have basically oodles of experience, and it's coming to the forefront now. And yeah. You can see that from looking at the scoreboards. Combined deaths of, what, 8? Call that 14, 20, 27 deaths over... best part of we're now in the 14th round, so
yeah.
even if CRG do manage to pick up a round here, it's not like you're going to see VERYGAMES even close to an eco. So I think at minimum you're going to see an 11-4 scoreline, probably 12-3 though, to be quite honest.
Yeah, probably 12-3, but yeah, it's not impossible for CRG to pick up one or two rounds here. And it has to be said also that Team CRG did not pick up that pistol round.
Yeah.
If they did, this would be a completely different story.
Oh, for sure. It would be a respectable scoreline.
Yeah.
But then again, you're playing VERYGAMES pistol. And, you know, if VERYGAMES do have a strength over most teams, it's those pistol rounds. Anyway, we're seeing CRG starting to stack over towards Banana again. Now, it does seem like VERYGAMES have actually been a bit more passive on Banana here. They've given up the stack. Does seem like Scream's going to be playing the back of sight. Now he opens up with the AK, grabs the headshot into the back of Ben's head. Fairly messy shot, but did get the job done. Another one to follow it up, and a triple. Doesn't get the fourth, but Smith's on the counter rotation now, and that's going to shut down the Banana push. That is going to be the 11-3 scoreline. Like I said, 12-3, completely doable here. I think at 12-3, though, CRG can be... they don't have to be despondent about that. I think they've played well. The rounds that they've played and had the entry on Banana, they've made them entertaining at the very least. So I think they can walk away head tilt high from the first half. They don't need to be too downhearted about it. Obviously, there's things that they will need to address as a team, and I think it just boils down to more practice. Basically, they've got the strats down. They're obviously, you know, an integral part of the UK scene. It's just basically boiling down to the fact that Smiths and Kenny are just too much to handle.
Yeah, and I mean they've got three rounds, so they can afford to lose the pistol round in the second half. But if they win that pistol round, they have six
GG
rounds.
GG, pretty much, yeah. Good grenade there from CRG, just a little bit too late to catch Kenny on the the bedroom though. So yeah, now seeing Kenny just holding down apartments. As you can see, we already have blood on that wall, so if somebody has been tagged, I would probably say that would be Spuds. Either Spuds or Drone. Let's find out where Drone is right now, see if it was Drone. Probably not Drone, to be honest, because he's coming around from the library side here as he opens up with the pistol.
Oh,
does
wow.
manage to grab a kill on the headshot. Ben with the AK frag as well, so bomb is going to be planted here, and it's now going to be a 2-on-2, but as you can see from the health, it's not looking good, is it, Walkline?
No, not far from it. Like, the T's have the advantage of being in that after-plant situation, but with the aim and consistency of VERYGAMES also going to attack at the very same time. Yeah, it's just Drone's not going to be able to do this at all. Wow, Smith, just another level.
I have a question for you.
Right.
Graveyard, the walls, are they penetrable now? I don't think so. I think the stone, and I think Source Engine is smart enough to differentiate, you know, between really thick stone and just, like, say, breeze block.
Well, yeah, it probably is that smart, and you can set, like, I think you could, in 1.6 also, you could set the value of the, well, let's say, call it armor.
Yeah.
Back in Half-Life 1 engine, it was smart enough. But I haven't played that much CS Global Offensive myself to actually know if that's penetrable. It's a bit embarrassing to say, really.
well, neither of us know, but...
I've played Source for the last couple of 5 years, so obviously wall spamming is not something that falls naturally to me anymore.
No, most definitely not. To any Source player, it doesn't come naturally.
Threat will answer that question later.
Threat would probably know the answer to that, actually. So we'll ask him later, because I do want to know that out of curiosity, because if it is penetrable, it makes that viable.
Yeah.
Now, pistol round, obviously, second half underway. Looks like VERYGAMES sort of getting the better of the initial engagements. A little bit of to and fro in here. Yeah, they seem to have done more damage to CRG, but it's not going to stop Red Snake on the double push. Grabs himself two headshots, Existence and Kenny. They seem to be pretty much tied to each other these days, Existence and Kenny, so shutting down the guys who play probably the tightest game together is going to be a huge deal here. VERYGAMES, though, not really giving up. I mean, they're still pushing up mid. They're going to be going towards quad side. It looks like Ben's going to be shut down here if he's not careful.
MBK, not a lot of
13 HP,
here.
Though. Good grenade. That's going to force him away from the site. That's going to allow VERYGAMES the entry with a flashbang to follow it up. There should be a frag. It's not, though. There's the frag eventually. Too much damage was done, though. Smith with just 12 HP. Let's drop you onto Smith now. He's putting the bomb down here.
Oh, that's golden.
So he has got the plant. So more money for VERYGAMES. Not that it particularly matters at this point, but... considering they did have a 12-3 first half, but there's a chance here that Smith is going to clutch. Well, Drone's not having any of that. He's going to go in for the defusal now. That's going to be, hopefully, three rounds on the board here for Team CRG, which should make it a 12-6 scoreline. And to be honest, if the game finishes 16-6, I think CRG, they're not going to be ecstatic about that, obviously. They're not going to be ecstatic about losing, period.
No.
But I think they can walk away and not be shamed by that.
If they want six rounds, then they will be having to fight for it, because VERYGAMES, they let VERYGAMES get that plant, which means that the next round...
potential early buy.
It's going to be an early buy.
Yep.
If they do manage to kick VERYGAMES' ass that round, then they might as well try to go all the way, to be fair.
Yep. Let's see where you're coming from on that point. It's just it's kind of a... an unfortunate situation now that CRG find themselves in, because they did concede that bomb plant. Good chance they're not going to get the two eco bashes here, like Clown just said. So really now, with sort of Team CRG pushing out, playing aggressive, there's even a chance here that they're going to lock this down as a very acceptable round for them. But the quicker they end this round, the quicker they're probably going to lose to a light buy, aren't they?
Yeah. Oh, Red Snake. Utilizing that P90, which is so great in this game. I really enjoy playing with it, and
it was good in CSS, but in goal now it's almost criminal not to buy it if you want shits and giggles at the end of the day.
Yeah, and I kind of feel like the biggest public noob ever when I use it, but it's a new game. You just have to embrace the changes.
Yep.
And running around with a shotgun or P90. Or Glock even, it's not considered bad anymore. It's considered like... Oh,
no,
right,
it's considered the advisable thing to do, to be quite honest, in certain situations.
Weapons.
I mean, if I was holding apartments today, there's a very good chance I would use the shotgun.
Yeah.
At least on light buys, anyway. I mean, obviously, because it's going to cost you less than the M4 or AWP, so it's a very viable investment these days.
Do you know how much money you get off of a kill with a shotgun?
I would say, rather than say make myself look like a fool, how much?
$900 per kill.
What?
So it's actually quite a good anti-eco weapon.
I have never actually noticed that, and I have played with the shotgun, and I wondered why I was like top fragging in the server with no effort, because the shotgun, I mean, it's accurate to mid-range.
Yeah.
There's no real spread on it. Now you've just told me you're getting 900. Why aren't everyone playing with shotguns?
Yeah,
it should be 5v5 shotguns on a GG map or something.
Well, I mean, it's so good to use against the... it's a cheap weapon, and use it against ecos. You'll still win the eco, and you rack up 3 kills. Times 900. Oh, that's a lot of money.
Well, speaking of money, it looks like VERYGAMES here potentially going to take the ascendant position. It's a 3-on-2 with 3 AKs in play against a P90 and an M4. Obviously, with body armor, that P90 does become a less attractive weapon to use. Now, Scream opens up from pit, again, emphasizing the importance of controlling that approach from pit. It completely locks Quad down, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's the perfect backup player for all the other teammates holding their own angles and their own exits. If they hear a sound or need help, he can flash or help with the
Or just switch your own statue, yeah. And then he's covering a completely different angle.
Exactly.
It's kind of an OP spot, to be honest, but there's ways of anti-stratting against it. I mean, if you tie it in with an apartments rush, you flash out of apartments, you flash from quad, that will get you in 9 times out of 10.
Yeah, and you can smoke it up as well.
Exactly, yeah. I mean, there are ways, but like we discussed earlier, that then stops, you know, it frees up the guys who are actually on site or library to come in and just dick you from behind, so... best of a bad situation, I suppose. All you can really do in that situation when somebody like Smiths is dug in as deep as that is try and dislodge him with combination of HE, smoke and flash.
Well, Ben's playing a bit offensive with the $900 gun. Not going to go any further than that, just holding that bedroom area.
I'm surprised that we're seeing VERYGAMES showing CRG as much respect as they are, but I think that's probably because they want to close this game out as early as possible, to be honest. I think if this would have happened 3 or 4 hours ago, they'd be probably running around at this point, you know, dual elites and things like that, just having a giggle. But being that we are now, what time are we on? We're coming up on 5-1 now by my watch. I haven't adjusted it, so yeah, it should be 5-1. It's obviously, you know, they've been playing all day since, what time was our first game? Half 10. So you are looking at beyond 12 hours now, and that's usually sort of, you know, the breaking point for most gamers.
Yeah, we as casters have already broken down multiple times.
Yeah, let's be honest about it. I mean, there was a point where I was sat in the beanbags during the analysis, and literally, you saw my leg spaz out.
Yeah.
You know, the whole monkey sort of subsystem of my brain kicked in and kept me awake, thank God. But I was mere seconds away from falling asleep on what would have been, you know, doing the analysis, a very awkward time because I wouldn't know what had gone on. So, just one of those things. Obviously, long days. It's all part and parcel of LAN. And we are seeing Scream and Smith hold down this banana bomb site. Smith with his second frag of the round, both of them headshots. Last time I checked his headshot ratio, it wasn't CSS, but he was way up above 35%, which in CSS was astronomical. Go, it does seem to be, well, not so much anymore, they've changed the tap, but it did seem to be a little bit easy to make headshots in at least the last full version that was rolled out.
Well, yeah, I'd have to say that I agree. Not that it's easier, but the hitboxes are a lot better developed and programmed in the Global Offensive.
Yep.
So basically, it's not easier, but you don't have the bug that actually makes the hitbox actually follow the model.
Yeah. You don't have any lag behind, basically. That was largely addressed in the orange box, you know, remake of CSS to the point where it wasn't as much of an issue. But to be honest, most people then found that, you know, because they had configs on and such, it screwed up all the configs. They couldn't find the right interp settings, and it did force. I mean, it was a positive change, but it did force a lot of people out of the scene initially. So it was kind of misfortunate for CSS in the European scene when the orange box came out. I think it made it a better game eventually after, you know, about 2 or 3 months, but. Still, I mean, ideally, the changes should have been made and tested before released. Now, we are seeing VERYGAMES here. Looks like they are going to be shutting down just